Hello, it's Kick-Ass Woman time. I'm Jenny Dye, author of the Breaking Chronicles. But I'm not writing. I love to learn about kick-ass women in history. And I'm here today to tell you about one of them. Little Manya was only 4 years old in 1871. Her parents were teaching her to speak their native Polish, but she had to be certain to never speak it outside their home if she didn't want her parents to land in prison. That's a heavy load for a four-year-old. Poland hadn't been an independent country for almost a century. Warsaw was controlled by the Russian czar, who tried to stamp out Polish nationalism by keeping the people ignorant of their language and culture. But Polish patriots, like Manya's parents, were determined to not only retain both their culture and their language, but to ultimately regain control of their nation. Manya's parents were both educators, but they weren't allowed to teach in certified schools under the repressive czarist regime. Manya, tutored by her parents at home, was the star pupil in her class and graduated at age 15. Because women weren't allowed at the University of Warsaw, Manya and one of her sisters, Bronya, attended an illegal night school dubbed the Flying University. It got its name because the location was changed frequently to help evade the watchful eyes of the authorities. These sisters understood the value of education. But what were they going to do to reach their dreams? They both wanted to go to medical school. They thought about long and hard and decided they would have to help each other. So the two sisters made a pact. Manya would work to put her sister through medical school in Paris. And as soon as she could, Bronya would reciprocate to help Manya go to school. In between working hard to support her sister, Manya filled her hours with self-taught studies. Not sure what she was really interested in, she studied sociology, literature, physics, and chemistry. She discovered that math and the physical sciences were her strength and passion. When she was 24, Manya was finally able to leave for France to begin studies at the University of Paris, the famous Sorbonne. Manya became Marie when she enrolled at the university while also working as a governess. She was horribly lonely, but being alone meant she was able to concentrate on her studies, which was a good thing. Because of her lack of academic preparation in Poland, she was far behind the other students, especially in the physical sciences, which the Russians had outlawed in Polish schools. Her proficiency in technical French was lacking, and her mathematical background was lacking. What wasn't lacking was her passion to learn. The world of science was finally open to her. Well, Marie was like a sponge. It didn't take her long to catch up, and then she just flew past everyone else. Marie's ferocious studying paid off when she finished her master's degree in physics just 2 years later, at the top of her class. Then she started her second master's degree in math, but there was a problem. The math degree required lab work, and there was no lab available to her at the university. Well, she just did what any kick-ass woman would do. She started looking for one. Her search for lab space resulted in an introduction to another scientist who had done pioneering research on magnetism. His name was Pierre Curie. This introduction would change not only their individual lives, but also the course of science. They were married a year later. Little Manya was now Marie Curie. Pierre, deeply intrigued and respectful of Marie's brilliance, helped her every way he could, and Marie did the same for him. Their lives were fraught with deprivation and difficulties due to lack of funding and adequate lab facilities. But both of them understood the importance of their research, so they ignored their personal discomfort and pain. Because they did, their impact on science and medicine is legendary. Known best for her discovery of the radioactive elements of polonium and radium, Marie went on to become the first person to win 2 Nobel Prizes. Her radium was a key to the basic change in scientific understanding of energy and matter, and her work not only influenced science, but also began an entirely new era in medical research and treatment, one you benefit from right now. In the midst of all her successes, however, there was tragedy. She'd been married to Pierre for only 11 years when he was tragically killed when crossing a street in Paris. He slipped and fell under a heavy horse-drawn cart, dying instantly when one of the wheels ran over his head. He was only 47. Marie was left alone to raise their 3 children and continue her research. And, of course, this kick-ass woman did just that. but she paid a heavy price for her work. During her research, she experienced radium burns, both accidentally and voluntarily. She was exposed to extensive doses of radiation, not understanding how dangerous it was. She discovered the cost when she died of aplastic anemia caused by all the radiation when she was just 66. We understand the dangers of radiation now. Even now, all their papers, even her cookbooks, are too dangerous to touch. Their laboratory books are kept in special lead boxes. People who want to see them have to wear protective clothing. Marie Curie died from her research, but she has saved millions of lives. Marie dedicated most of her time during World War I to install X-ray machines in hospitals because it made it easier for doctors to locate shrapnel in injured soldiers and people. Over 11 million soldiers were examined with these X-ray machines. We now know that too much X-ray exposure is bad, but it has also helped to save millions of lives. You know, as a female child growing up in an occupied country, Manya could have come up with all kinds of excuses why she couldn't finish school, go to college, or persevere in her career choice. But she didn't. Marie Curie took the steps necessary to move from one level of life to the next. She faced each obstacle, found a solution, performed it with excellence, and moved forward. That is my definition of a kick-ass woman. And that's all for today. Subscribe to my channel below because I'll be adding many more stories of other kick-ass women. And if you want to check out my best-selling historical novel series that focuses on some pretty amazing kick-ass women, you can use the link below to buy the first one for just 99 cents. And as long as you're clicking things, I'd appreciate a like if that's true for you. Have a great day, and I'll be back soon.